Every release of Onshape includes performance enhancements that improve overall responsiveness and user experience. Some are more noticeable than others. In this latest release, the graphics data of large, natively modeled assemblies has been optimized so that less data is transferred to the browser on document open. We expect to see a reduction in document load times and RAM usage when working with large assemblies, particularly ones that haven't been recently opened. As you can see, this V-twin engine design now opens at about 5 seconds, compared with 11 seconds in the previous deployment, over a 50% improvement. Onshape's hole feature now allows users to define tolerances with negative and zero values, giving you more flexibility in how you define your geometry. This will now allow you to apply plus plus, minus minus, and unilateral tolerances to your whole geometry to represent both the nominal size and the fit type with any mated geometry, such as pins. With this release, we've given you a new tool in your sketching tool belt, elliptical arc. This sketch feature allows you to create partial ellipses with full control over both the direction and magnitude of the major and minor axes. You will find this reduces the number of steps required to create many different types of geometry, such as the handle of this steam iron. This update brings users additional flexibility and control in their management of metadata with Onshape's custom properties. For properties with a predefined set of options, such as the plating of a part, Onshape provides a convenient list property type. Administrators now have the ability to add list values, make values inactive, change the order of the list, and even edit the display names of already published properties with a convenient new user interface. When an option is made inactive, existing elements with that selection will continue to display appropriately, but will include a prompt to update away from the inactive property.
The Onshape Bill of Materials functionality is now available for users on iOS. Simply choose the flyout panel on the right-hand side and choose a flattened or structured view of the BOM. Cross-highlighting is available between the graphics area and the table view. This also works with versions and workspaces. Here, I can choose to open up the engineering change order for a released version of this IoT device and see the bill of materials as it existed at that time. Also note that if fields are wider than what you can read in the column, you can see the full name at the bottom of the screen. We hope this enhances your ability to access parts lists and bill of materials from anywhere in the world using Onshape for iOS. Exciting new user interface changes have been implemented for the iOS version of Onshape. We've adopted a more Apple-style indicator for the left-hand splitter. So if you're on the iPad, you've noticed that you've got navigation menus off on their own page into the sidebar, which you can turn on and off. The active section is highlighted so you can easily keep track of where you are and open the document. But that's not all. We've also redesigned the settings view to match the new split view enhancements. User settings now receive a new interface, making it easier than ever to access standard preferences like default units. Notifications will also appear at the bottom of the page. Onshape Enterprise accounts with mobile access requirements now also get to take advantage of the new iOS redesign for Onshape, with the analytics and activity panels now available for quick access.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.